Welcome back, fellow Helldivers. I've been getting a lot of questions about how I'm able to get ray tracing in my gameplay and what reshade effects I'm using to get higher quality lighting. So, I thought I'd make this video to go in depth and show you how to get a similar look in your game. Hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe if you're new to this channel. Now, on with the video. Marty McFly, aka Pascal Glitcher, has worked on many reshade shaders, but his most famous one is the Ray Tracing Global Illumination, or RTGI. His work on this shader actually landed him a job at NVIDIA, working on Freestyle SSRTGI. Sadly, Freestyle only works on games NVIDIA allows, and Helldivers 2 is not one of them. There is a workaround I've used previously to get it working on the 2014 game Watch Dogs. It upgraded the lighting so well in that game, and I'll leave a link in the description if you want to see more of that. Unfortunately, GameGuard's anti-cheat makes this workaround not viable for Helldivers, so that leaves us with using the older Immerse RTGI. That's okay though, because this shader can upgrade the lighting quality of any game running in DirectX 9 or newer, as long as Reshade can properly grab the game's depth buffer. This is how the raw depth data looks. Kinda cool looking, but you might have noticed something. Volumetric fog is missing from the depth data. This is because it's a post-processing effect added after the rasterization of the game, and this will come up later as something we'll need to try and work around. I'm not going to go through the process of showing how to install Reshade, because that was covered in my last video, and I'll leave a link in the description for it. I'll also leave a link to join Pascal Glitcher's Patreon so you can get access to his Immerse RTGI shader. He also has a community Discord with tons of helpful information to help you set up the shader, and it even has presets for some games. My goal with this video is to show you how great this game can look with ray tracing, show you the settings I'm using to achieve this look, and maybe give some helpful tips along the way. In a side-by-side comparison between the vanilla game and my reshade settings, there is a massive difference. The ambient occlusion gets a substantial upgrade with RTGI, especially when looking at ground rubble and vegetation. In Helldivers 2, the ambient occlusion method used is SSAO. This is an older algorithm used to darken areas within the screen space when polygons of objects are in close proximity. This method is quick and less resource intensive than, say, HBAO+. However, it won't be able to correctly darken vegetation and ground tessellation, as these parts of the rasterization pipeline are not taken into account. Another big difference you'll notice is how RTGI will darken a more general area, like a dense forest or when you're underneath a large rock face. This game's ambient occlusion won't take this into account either, so these areas will seem to be almost glowing in comparison. This method of injecting screen space ray tracing will not be a magic bullet though. As I alluded to earlier, volumetric fog is not taken into account, so this will cause some unintended interactions, especially when there are intense, full-screen volumetrics like in this example. Luckily, we can mitigate a lot of this with the help of a few other shaders that I'll get into. So, let's enable ray tracing. Check the box for RT Global Illumination to turn it on, and let's tweak a few settings. First, check the box for Assume sRGB Input. This will fix the weird glow that appears on the edges of occluded objects, and instead make them darker as they should be. Next, let's change the ambient occlusion intensity from the default of 4 to 20. This will make the darkening effect of ambient occlusion stronger and more widespread. It will also look much better in certain cases, like when there are lots of objects nearby, but not close enough that standard AO would darken the area. For example, between big boulders or in heavy tree cover. Now let's enable the 4 advanced effects. Flip all the zeros to 1 to enable them, except for sky color mode. Sky color mode affects the color of bounce lighting, since every planet is a different color, and the sky changes colors between the day and night cycle. Setting this to 2 will dynamically change the color and intensity of bounce lighting from the sky. Scroll up and set sky color intensity to 0.5, or 0.1 if you have the in-game bloom on. Also, set the image base lighting to 0.1. This will add a slight amount of color to dark regions based on the planet's color rather than being just gray. Finally, here's how the ray trace global illumination looks by itself. Don't forget to move RTGI to the top of the list so it's applied first, or right below AMD Fidelity FX Cast if you're using that for upscale sharpening. This looks pretty good compared to before, but with reshade we can take the lighting as a whole to the next level. Enable the shader levels and set the black point to 12. This will fix the issue of dark areas looking too light, as well as making intensely bright areas like the sun and point lights look as bright as they should be. Have you noticed just how bright this scene is? It's supposed to be the middle of the night, but it almost looks like overcast daytime, especially before we added the other two shaders. So, to resolve this, enable curves. I like to use anywhere between 0.5 and 0.7, and this will depend on how bright your monitor is. Since mine is very bright, I like to go higher. However, 0.5 is a decent place for this video since I don't know if you're watching this on a TV or a phone right now. The final shader I use is Vignette. This gives the game a nice filmic ambiance, and you can even take this one step further with even more shaders like film grain, chromatic aberration, color correction, CRT scanlines. Essentially, with reshade, you can tweak the game's visuals to look however you want to. So, here's a comparison between the vanilla game versus ray tracing and all our other lighting tweaks. It's a pretty substantial difference, and with the in-game bloom turned on, point lights really pop. Here are two more comparisons between the vanilla and reshade. Once again, the new lighting actually looks like nighttime, and the point lights have more pop. Before I end this video, I should let you know that this form of ray tracing has a really substantial performance impact on the GPU. This is software ray tracing, so even if you have an NVIDIA card, you're still going to take a hit. Luckily, I only saw a 5% decrease in performance, since this game is CPU bound and doesn't really make my GPU work very hard. I also enabled a 60 FPS cap on the game, because this will reduce RT ghosting artifacts, since RTGI struggles at higher FPS. So, there you have it. Ray tracing in Helldivers 2 using reshade can take your gameplay to the next level of visual quality. Thank you to my super subscriber Jordan for helping make this video possible. If you'd like to support my channel and help me make more videos like this one, consider becoming a super subscriber today. You'll also receive cool perks like early access to videos, get shoutouts and badges, and even a free super chat each month. Thank you so much for watching. Now get out there and spread some democracy.
Spot outpost!